We're watching the most insane clips of Karens and Kevins that have gone viral this week. Let's jump in. Karens always complain about something, and this time it's the fact that she can't run over kids playing in the street.
Listen, we have a problem with you. We have a problem when I can't drive home from work every goddamn day because your kids are in the f***ing road.
They're not in the road.
They're playing?
Every day!
The cones are out there.
They're on their bikes!
The cones down, and they're over here.
No, they're not. You're out of your mind. They're on this side of the street. This is slow you down. Good. Take a picture. We'll have the police department here so he can give you a ticket.
Call
you freaking psycho. We have.
You literally just said you're going to go 45 on our street tomorrow. Did your kids never play on bikes in the street?
I never put cones out in the road and try to redirect traffic like I own the goddamn place. Never did it. And I don't act like an asshole and run out in traffic trying to play people down like
stop going down
when
our street.
You're going
then. Take
45, 50
Take
miles an hour.
Wheel. You don't live here.
And leave them calls out and see what happens.
You don't live here.
Oh my God.
Everyone watch out! There's a drunk Karen on the loose, and she doesn't like any of us.
Yes, I can.
Hey,
no, because of heat from the car. And if it smells, it's
why do you have
alcohol.
Paint on your chest, you dirty
well, you
listen,
drink a lot.
It's powder.
Listen, which one do you like out
I'm
of all
clean.
Of us?
You drink a lot?
I don't like any of you.
How do you know my name, though?
Don't you worry about that.
You use my license plate?
Don't you, like, adult? Don't you worry about Joel's
name?
Joel Pacheco? Y'all hang out there all the time. You're just like,
What's up, guys? Today, the Unluggy channel is back with another video. We've combed the crevices of the internet and discovered the most unhinged and unfriendly Karens and Kevins. So strap yourself in and get ready to speak to the manager. Let's dive in. This clip proves that Karens can be everywhere, and that's a bit worrying, especially when there's health involved. I don't think this Karen has any bedside manner.
What were you thinking about when you got pregnant that you were not going to work? I'm just curious, because, like, I've had three kids. I worked up until the second day was born.
But am I you? Are you me? Do you know how I feel? Do you know
yeah,
how
that
feels?
That's why I'm asking. I'm interested to know what you think. I want to know your mindset. So when you got pregnant, what were you thinking about?
I was thinking about having a kid. I'm confused on where you're going at.
I'm confused, too, because you came in here and I did an assessment and I gave you my best medical advice.
Uh-huh.
And
okay.
You didn't like that.
But I said that I just wanted a note so I could take it easy these next 2 months.
And
I'm 7 months pregnant and I'm in
fraud.
Pain.
We have to
it's
have
not fraud. If it was fraud, the doctor wouldn't be getting me my note right now.
Really?
Yes.
What I read on your chart isn't true.
Okay.
So
what's
I know
on my
fraud.
Chart that's not true?
I read on your chart what isn't true. Because I'm the person who saw you and did the exam.
Okay.
So it's okay.
But how do you know how I feel? How do you know how my body feels inside?
Because I stuck my hand in there and checked your
cervix. Okay, you checked my cervix, but how do you know how my bones feel? How do you know how my body feels? My legs, my back. How do you know how that feels?
So
how do you know how my nausea feels? How do you know how my cramps feel? By touch. And you're okay. All right.
No,
so this is the nurse practitioner.
You know
and look how she's hitting me. Look how she look at it. Check her out.
I'm
check it out. Call the police. And they're going to see what you just did.
Yeah, because you're
call the police. She already called the police on me once because
yes,
I called her a weirdo. Yes. Look at you. This
okay,
lady is okay. Crazy. Call the cops again. Call them.
It's okay.
I got you on video hitting me with that thing in your hand.
This
is the Philly Pregnancy Center, guys.
Kevin here is ready to waste the police times for any trivial reason. But somehow this police officer is not happy.
I live right there, and I've lived there for 7 years. I've lived there for longer than him, but he doesn't want me to park in front of his house because he apparently has 5 cars that he needs to park here. So they're trying to bully me, which they do to every neighbor. They leave nasty notes on every neighbor's car, swearing at people not to park in front of their house. And this thinks I'm threatened by her opening. She opened my car door.
Where's your car? It's not here. It's not here.
Call the bylaws and they'll come get a ticket.
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
That's up to the city bylaws. You got to call them. That's too bad. Get a sign here that says residents of this block only. Get a sign.
My God, it's already there tonight.
Okay, so well, she's working here. It's too late.
Why is it too late? I'm still here.
Because I've been here for half an hour. Okay, I'm going to park while you're still here so that they don't do the same once you leave.
Can you believe this male Karen is so unhelpful to this customer, all because he won't admit he's wrong? I doubt he'll have his job after this video goes viral.
Do you have a supervisor or some kind of a manager phone number for here?
I know,
but he has to have a boss.
Of course I do, but he won't. He'll contact you and tell me what I told you.
What did you tell me? I'm sorry. Besides
whatever
erasing
you
my stuff.
Lost is gone.
Okay, can I ask why you erased my phone?
I did not lose your phone. I have no idea.
I didn't ask you to lose my phone. I asked you, why did you erase my phone?
So whatever is gone is gone. I'm sorry.
Okay, but why did you erase my phone? What was the reason for erasing my phone? Can I ask?
I personally have not.
I don't understand what you're saying to me.
That's fine.
And I don't think you understand what you're saying.
No, I understand that whatever could not have been,
you friends?
No, don't talk to me. Whatever has been, replaced to your phone.
You were supposed to hook up my watch. That's what you were supposed to do. You were supposed to hook up my watch. And that's what you were in the middle of doing, hooking up my watch. And then you selected to restore my phone. Like, I don't understand what you're doing.
Restore your watch to your phone.
What are you saying? So, they told me to bring my watch in. Because I bought a new watch and I currently have a plan.
Yep.
Okay?
Sure.
So, they told me to bring my watch in. And something with the IEM number so you guys can connect my network, my data plan to my new device.
Sure.
And what did my phone have to do? You erased my phone.
I did not erase your phone.
You just clearly erased my phone.
No, I did not erase
your
phone.
Here, do you want to see? You erased my phone.
Then your phone's been erased, but
right.
I did not erase your phone.
I'm sorry, then who just did it? The gentleman that was just back there, which was you, helping me, who erased my phone?
We did not erase your phone.
Okay, then what did you do to my phone?
I have no idea. I don't remember, but...
No. You don't remember. I would like to talk to somebody above you.
What did we do to your phone?
You erased my phone.
Were we trying to respect, or what were you doing?
Trying to respect, what does that mean?
What were we doing to your phone?
You were nothing. You were supposed to be hooking up my new watch.
But someone on your phone got erased.
Kevin's meltdown at the gas station just because someone is in his spot is just childish, to say the least. Take a look.
Homie thought if he yelled at me,
you
I would leave.
This is not your spot.
You don't talk to me.
You need to go back
you
in
don't
line.
Even talk to me.
You need to go back in line.
To me.
You understand?
I'm recording you.
Get in line.
I'm recording you.
That's all right.
Stop
Record
talking to
me.
Record me.
I have not done anything.
Okay, stop talking
Get
to me.
Get in line.
Stop talking to me.
Get in line.
Stop talking to me.
Like everybody else. Get in line.
Okay, what is your problem? Go.
Get in line.
Go in line. Go wherever you want.
Get
I don't care.
In line.
I don't care.
Get in line.
Dude, I have my four kids in the car.
Get
so
in
I need
line.
You to be quiet and leave me alone.
Get in line.
I'm
like everybody else.
For some reason, I feel like this Karen wasn't impressed with this haircut. Would you have been impressed with that finished product?
Much worse than this. It's exactly the polar opposite. You couldn't have done much worse unless you bumped my head off. Do you get that?
Yes.
Oh my gosh. I am past frustrated.
Watch this Karen have a freak out at a guy who is just trying to do his job. He didn't know what he was going to have to deal with.
What?
No,
what?
No.
What?
No, we are not here. You do not get to be in my neighborhood.
What is your problem? Leave me alone. You attacked me last week. I actually came to your door and knocked on the door. You left.
This Australian Karen's racist freakout is wild. All because an employee tried to clear her table. I doubt she'll be coming back after this video. The subway is the quickest way to travel and the quickest way to get Karen to reveal her true anti-Semitic ways.
You're Jewish and you're talking to me like this?
I'm Jewish. I'm Greek.
You're Orthodox?
I'm Greek.
Yeah? Well, don't talk to me this way. I have Greek friends.
It's none of your business if I want to know where he's going.
No other right to speak to the driver. If you want to get out, ask to get out.
Wait, you would for him?
Hey. Right? I don't like the way you talk to me, miss.
I
don't like the way you talk to me, that's it. Don't talk to me this way. Watch how this racist Karen tries to excuse her threatening behavior with a taser with absolute lies. Somehow, I don't think that this was worth the police warning it resulted in.
Dog. The dog attacked my dog.
The dog's not even outside, ma'am.
He was outside. He was in front here.
Where's your dog injured? He attacked him. Where's your dog?
He didn't attack the dog. I have it on camera.
You know what?
What?
You guys are acting like black people, and you should act like black people.
Wait, what?
You're acting like Karen.
I was raised in Oklahoma.
Wait, can you repeat that one more time? We're acting like what?
I was raised in Oklahoma City, where there were tons of black people.
But we're acting like what?
You're acting like people that aren't normal.
Okay. This will be real nice when you're on the news, when you're on social media, get the fuck off
property. Get off our property. Get off our property.
You know, I have a top secret clearance.
I don't give a fuck, bitch. Get the fuck off the property.
Go back in the house. Go back in the house. Since we're acting like black people. Right? We're acting like black people, and that's not normal.
Most people don't act like you do.
How are we acting? How are we acting? You came over here with a taser.
You came over here because your pit bull attacked my little dog.
He didn't attack your dog. Not at all.
Your son was out here with it.
And he didn't attack the dog. I saw you pet the dog. You pet the dog.
I didn't pet the dog. I just pet the dog because I wanted to see if he was okay.
You didn't pet the dog, but you pet the dog because you wanted to see if he was okay.
Why don't you record all this? And put it on?
I am recording it. You about to be famous.
Do you know what? You're going to go?
You're about to be famous. Where am I going to go?
You're going to go to hell.
Okay.
Because I'm going to sue the hell out of you, both of you.
All right.
All of you.
Go. All right.
Get out.
Hello?
Hey.
Where are you?
Right over here. How you doing?
You're a little tiny fool.
Kevin wants a refund, but doesn't understand that he can't get one because he's touched the food.
Here you go, man. I'm so sorry that, but here's the number for the corporate.
No. We want our money back, sir.
I can't give you the money back.
You can't give me my money back.
You can call.
I haven't touched the food. I was here just for.
You can record me all you want. Doesn't matter. It's not gonna make a difference.
I'm gonna send it to corporate so that they can see that you couldn't refund me my money.
I can't.
You're telling
me
you can't.
My boss does not allow that. So you call tomorrow morning and you can give back your money.
They can't give me a refund.
We can't take back the food because of COVID.
Fine, that's
fine. Are you recording that? That's COVID.
That's fine. I won't hand you the food. It's fine. But we just want our money back.
I'm gonna have the cops have you escorted. This is private property, sir.
You messed up our order. You're gonna make us pay for food that you messed up?
Karen and his Karen sidekick are at the beach and being real beaches.
Is that yours?
Oh, yeah, but we don't know how to do it.
Oh, you need some help?
You know how to do it?
Yeah, this is our stuff.
This is yours?
Yes. No, it is. This is all ours. All of it. The chairs, the bag, this is all our stuff. My kids, yep, that's my kids. I'm sorry. Yeah.
Linda, we didn't bring,
It's okay. We'll let it slide, but I'm glad I made it in time.
No, I'm not making it slide. I'm telling you.
No, step away from my sh**. How about that?
And then I'm gonna take that camera and put it in the grass. Are you gonna like that? Step back. Stop it.
Seriously?
When this Karen tries to play the victim card and calls the police, you won't believe what happens next.
Tell him to shut the camera off now.
By law, I can't.
Honest to God, this shows up on YouTube. Robinson Township, I'm coming after and
you're
I'm coming
shoot
after
me
you.
For what? I suggest you get in your vehicle, sit on.
Don't touch me.
Get off.
Don't
shut
touch
it off.
Me. Don't
shut
touch
it
me.
Off now.
Ma'am, go sit in your vehicle.
I do not like my picture taken.
Ma'am, listen to me. Sit in your vehicle.
Tell him to shut it off now.
Go sit in your vehicle. He can't take you, okay? Go sit in your vehicle. I'm
I do not
this
want
up.
This on YouTube. I don't want ma'am, to. Tell him to shut it off now.
But shut the camera
shut it off bit,
okay?
now.
Okay, it's
ma'am,
off.
Get in your
shut
vehicle,
it off
okay?
now.
It's off.
Shut it off. Put the goddamn thing in your car now.
Listen.
No.
Get in your vehicle or I'm going to arrest you for creating a disturbance, okay? Do you understand me? Sit down. Let me write this up. We'll get everybody underway.
He's taping me again.
Ma'am.
He's taping me again. I do not like that stuff. I do not like that stuff.
You won't believe what lengths this male Karen will go to play the victim in the store. Take a look.
All back here, and Tesco's in the Dublin Road, right? Look at his face. Get this viral, right? Right? Get this viral. I have my pup in this store, right? The pup, somebody was messing, somebody touched my dog, and a bottle dropped down on me. Come on, big lad. Who the f*** do you think you're pushing? I swear to God, who do you think you're pushing? Yes, get the police and get the CCTV. This will be going viral. This will be going, who do you think you are? Who do you think you are? Who do you think you are? I'll tell you what, I'll drop you. Get away from me. Get away out of my face. You've been warned. Step away before I defend myself.
Nothing says racism more than screaming opera at people. Way to go, Karen.
I can sing. I am an opera singer.
We don't play.
And you can too. Oh, Canada. Okay. Well, it's enough. This is enough.
Karen seemed to all think that they're right, even when committing a crime, as this clip shows. This 7-Eleven employee deserves a standing ovation and a raise for how he dealt with this Karen. Needless to say, she won't be returning to that store.
Karen's B-Line.
And I'm a standing one of him. I've been here 4 years. She ain't gonna come in here and try to hurry up in this mother. Get the f*** out of here with your raggedy ass. You trying to help your stupid and you want to come up here with that bullshit? You. F*** you. Get the f*** out now. Get your scallywag, ugly ass, the f*** up out of here, raggedy ass. Bye. Next. I ain't never heard of a not understanding how to read. You can't read, you can't write. You come over here on the motherfucking phone. Bitch, don't ever come to the motherfucking register on the phone. So fuck you with a big dick and everything else. Like
Kevin's racist freak out here just highlights how much of a coward he actually is. Maybe next time he should try confronting someone his own size.
Plus you're f***ing cool, right? Red girls? Oh yeah, you're right. Huh, you're f***ing right. You're always f***ing right, aren't you? You're always f***ing right.
I don't even need to get on my face.
I'm not weird.
You are very rude. Because you're rude for nothing.
No,
you're rude. Nobody say nothing to
you. No, you're rude.
So don't be disrespectful to me.
You're rude because you're white.
For what?
Because you're black.
I don't care. I'm big black.
No.
What's the problem? What you gonna do about it?
The problem is
what
you gonna do about it?
What you gonna do about it?
How much are
you? Take advantage of being
649.
White? Where are you?
Me?
Yeah, where are you?
I'm beneath you.
You're what?
I'm beneath you.
Why? Why?
Because I'm white.
You're supposed to be equal.
Because I'm white.
Why?
Because I'm white. How much are you?
649.
Because I'm white.
So why are you beneath me? We're supposed to be equal. Well,
no.
You
No, because I'm white.
I'm sorry you
said
that.
No, you said it.
Why do you feel that way?
No.
Because nobody was disrespecting you. So don't come up here disrespecting me. We're having a personal conversation. We didn't do anything to you. You were loud. We were stopping our conversation because we heard you yelling over there.
No, I
didn't say anything to you.
I said shut up over there.
For what? What are you being disrespectful
of? I'm not being disrespectful.
You were over there talking about shut the f*** up. For what?
Because
what
you were speaking loudly about shit you don't know.
So what do you know?
I know a lot.
If you have an opinion, why can't you just state it like you were? We weren't arguing. We weren't cussing each other out for anything. So if you have an opinion, you can take it. All I did was ask you, what did he tell you about?
You're trying to say facts.
And what was the fact?
You're saying facts.
What was the fact? Obviously, you listened to the news. What was the fact? I'm listening.
Okay, Leticia. What's your name, Leticia?
No.
Shaniqua?
No.
What's your name?
What's your name?
649.
What's your name? Steve?
My name's Jeff.
Yeah.
White,
what's your name?
White piece of shit.
For what? Why are you beneath me? Why are you beneath me?
Because you're black.
What does that have to do with anything?
Because you
are still a human.
You
believe just like I do. So what's the problem?
No, because you guys all want your.
Are you racist? That's what you are? You're racist?
Oh my God.
So why are you saying black? Why are you saying because I'm black?
My grandson.
So you're beneath him? You're beneath him? Are you beneath him? I'm asking you. You brought it up. You said because I'm black.
Shaniqua.
That's not my name. That's not my name. You come to. Damn.
You're
sitting there talking about shut the up. You shut the up.
You're being sneaky.
No, I'm not. That's not my name. And what are you, John? What are you?
Whoa. Sorry. Ooh, you just
said all this. Okay, bye. Anyway.
Your total is 649, man.
You are exactly what the people think you are.
And so are you. Redneck. So what else?
Redneck?
Yeah, you're red. Your neck is actually red.
It is, I know.
It is. Because you have an attitude for nothing. Nobody was disrespectful to you. No, I didn't take you. I wasn't rude to you at first. You came over here talking about telling us to shut the f*** up for what? We're having a conversation. I'm asking him his opinion.
I'd hate to be in a confined space with these Karens. How would you react?
You come on. I'm not getting as well. No, don't tell me. You'll get boxed in the face. You want
to
get boxed?
You're not.
You
want to
get boxed?
You're not supposed to.
Get the f*** out. You can walk.
You can walk.
What do you think this is? Like, don't ever talk to me like in your life.
You're rich.
Shut the f*** up.
You
shut up.
Shut the f*** up. Back up.
You guys are idiots. Look, camera.
Kevins never admit that they're wrong, especially when it comes to mask mandates.
Required a mask? Okay, then we're gonna have to ask you to leave. I'm gonna have security to escort you out.
Seek help. Because you're so young, you don't know what Nazism.
It's our store policy and it's a privately owned company.
No, it's Nazism. And you're so young, you don't know what Nazism is. Because you weren't even born when Hitler took over and they used the exact same tactics. Don't get it. You don't get it.
Okay, well, I'm going to have to ask you.
You don't get it.
Okay, so I'm going to have to ask you to leave. We will not be able to help you today.
No, it's not that you won't be able to. You refuse to because you're idiots.
Well, because
you're an idiot. Okay, all right, here. I have a mask. What I'll do, I will comply to the requirement. Please. Put on a mask, and here's the mask. Here's the mask, and here's the mask. Here, I have it on. Okay. It's on. You've asked me to put it on.
Yeah, can you
so
just
I have
put
it on?
It over?
No, because
then
it doesn't.
That
know.
Defeats the no. whole purpose. Of
no, 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 no. I don't give a crap. I don't give a crap because this whole thing is a goddamn lie, and you're too stupid to understand it.
Well, I'm gonna have to ask you.
And if you're recording this whole thing, go ahead and record it.
Okay, well, I'm gonna have to ask
you. This anti-vax Kevin's meltdown at the hospital absolutely spirals out of control, and yet he still tries to play the victim.
And I'm getting assaulted. I'm getting kicked out of the hospital. I'm getting kicked out by right here. What's your name? What's your name?
You have to leave, sir.
I won't be leaving.
You have to leave.
I won't be leaving.
You have to leave.
This is my child.
I'm asking you to leave.
I won't be leaving with her, or I won't be leaving at all.
You will be leaving. Or Charlie Bay is going to be going on ejection from room 3 and they ready delivery. You have to leave, sir.
I'm going to stay here with my wife and my kid.
All right, I'm asking you to leave.
No.
Okay.
I'm staying here with my wife and my kid. I will not go anywhere. I'm staying here with my wife and my kid. I'm not going anywhere. You guys are on video. I'm not going anywhere. I'm staying with my wife and my kid. Do not touch me. You have no right. Do not touch me. You have no right. I am staying with my wife and my kid. Do not touch me. Do not touch me. I am with my wife and my kid. Do not touch me. This is wrong. You guys are so mean. COVID, look what's going on. The people are trying to kill me. These people are trying to kill me. Yes. They tell you one visitor, and then they try to kick you out. Look at this. Look at this.
Nobody's trying to kill you.
Yes.
Stop.
Just please leave. Please leave.
We're not leaving.
I'm not leaving. This is my wife and my kid. I'm not leaving my wife and my kid. And I would hope you would not leave your wife and kid either. And you wouldn't leave your wife and kid either, right? No. No, my wife is right there.
Come on, you gotta leave.
No, you guys are upset. Stop telling me. You people are upsetting my wife, who's about to have my baby, and you're trying to drag me out of the room.
I'm not dragging you
anywhere. You guys are trying to get me away from my baby. It's never going to happen. I'm never going to leave my child or my wife because of a COVID test. Do you understand me? Do you understand me that this is my right? This is my wife and she is crying right there. Look, that is my wife because of you. All you guys right here. COVID. They're kicking me out because I won't submit to a PCR test. A PCR test that's proven wrong.
Just give it a holler. You're the one upset.
No, I'm not.
You're coming, man. Come on.
I'm not going anywhere.
Come on, man. We're not fighting you.
If I had a dollar every time a Karen on this channel requested to see the manager, I'd finally be able to buy a house.
Are you the manager here?
Go away.
Are you the manager here?
Yeah, I am the manager.
What's
here.
Your name? You?
Yeah.
Can you spell it for me?
Can you go away?
May I please have your name?
Can you go away?
May I please have your name?
Who the f*** are you?
Why
are you harassing us? Why are you harassing us?
I'm not harassing you. You're the one with the phone in my face.
Yeah, because you're harassing me.
I'm literally asking your name. I'm just asking your name.
You won't get my name.
I'm just asking your name. Thank you. So what's your name? May I please have your name? May I please have your name? Why can't I have your name? May I please 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 have your name? He's not giving me his name.
Oh, is that so?
Yeah. He said his name is you.
Sikrela.
Okay. I think we're done here.
No, I'm still waiting for his name. May I please have your name?
We might be here a while.
Also, saying hello to someone is not considered harassment.
This, what you're doing right now is also harassment. That's why I'm filming it.
You're more than welcome to. I'm literally just asking your name.
Yeah, and I don't want to give it to you, and you keep harassing me.
May I please have your name?
No, you cannot.
May I please have your name?
You see? That's harassment.
Well, that's
and that's why I'm filming it.
And that is the same thing.
And that's why I told my employees to do when you're harassing them.